Hello children, in continuation with the properties of natural resources, today, yesterday I gave you one question, and that question is the to find out the density of the water, okay, to find out the density of the water whose weight is, whose mass is 1 liter and water's weight is 1 kg. So for that 1 liter is equals to, as we know that 1 liter is equals to 1 liter is equal to how much? 1000 milliliter, and 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. So mass is there, we will write here 1000 gram. Okay, conversion, 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram, and volume is equal to 1000 what? Cubic centimeter. So 1000 get cancelled with 1000. So answer is 1 gram per cubic centimeter is its answer. Okay, so how we find out the density? Mass we have to divide with the volume, then we got its answer is 1 kg per cubic centimeter, 1 gram per cubic centimeter. Okay, so next question is there, will the mass of the water changes when its state changes during the transformation of liquid into ice? So what they told you, its mass changes or not, that I told you to think, and nobody sent me this answer, so today you just think on it only. Next, it is the anomalous behavior of water that we will see. So first of all, we will see its video and then we will discuss about it. Okay.
The anomalous expansion of water plays an important role in the survival of aquatic animals and plants in cold countries. During winter season, as the temperature of water decreases, water at the surface of lakes, rivers, sea, etc. starts contracting. That is, its volume decreases and density increases. Hence, it sinks to the bottom. This process continues until the temperature of all the water in a lake falls to 4 degrees Celsius. Now, as the water at the surface cools below 4 degrees Celsius, it expands instead of contracting, and thus its density decreases. As a result, it becomes lighter than the rest of the water and remains on the surface of the lake. The temperature of this water goes on decreasing to 0 degrees Celsius, and finally it's converted into ice. As ice is a bad conductor of heat, water below surface layer remains at 4 degrees Celsius. As a result, fish and other aquatic animals remain alive in this water.
Now you saw the video which shows the anomalous behavior of water. So, what is anomalous behavior of water? We will see in detail now. So, first of all, for understanding, we will see the general questions here asking. Usually, when the temperature of substance is lowered, when the temperature of a substance is lowered, what happens? Density increases. What I said that temperature less, what happens? Density increases. Density increases. So, what happens? Temperature is less, density increases and volume decreases. What they told you, the things that is, when temperature of substance is less, then density and volume, both density increases, volume decreases. But water is the exception for this rule. Okay, water is the exception for this rule. What I told you, this thing can you keep in your mind, that is, when temperature of a substance decreases, density increases and volume decreases. Now, what they told you, keep a glass full of water. What we have to do, we have to take a glass of water and we have to keep in the freezer and we have to observe after 10 times. Then what they are asking to you, then take it out and observe it carefully. Okay, suppose this is a glass of a water. So you see the upper layer of the water, what happens, it turns to ice and the water is inside, the glass is in which state? Liquid state. And that is only the anomalous behavior of the water. So actually what happens, you now seen in the video, that if this glass is there, upper layer only turns into the ice, same thing is happening when there is a anomalous behavior of water inside. From which part of the glass the water freeze at first? It starts freezing from the top layer of the water. So the density, see here, what happened just now, this was the picture only you had seen. So here this temperature was there. Actually what happens, the temperature start decreasing. Till what temperature they told you, when the temperature decreases, it's as per other liquids. What they told you, as per other liquids, the water also follows the same rule. Okay, see, the density of water is peculiar when the water at normal temperature start cooling. At normal temperature, when water start cooling, at that time what happens, density increases at most of the liquid. Okay, so what happens, temperature decreases, density increases, that is happening with water also. But till which temperature? Till 4 degree Celsius. However, if its temperature falls 4 degree Celsius, now the temperature of the water is how much? 4 degree Celsius. Means whole layers, all the layers, just you seen that videos, how the temperature, what happens, changes and the water comes down. Okay, heavy water comes down, and what happens, this upside water, that lower water goes upside, and the same situation is happens here. And in that situation, till 4 degree Celsius, what happens, it follows the rule which other liquids are follows, and that is temperature, what happens, decreases, the density increases. Then however, now its temperature is 4 degree Celsius, at that time what happens, density starts decreasing. Here density decreasing, here the temperature start decreasing, then what happens, density increases. And here after 4 degree Celsius, density decreasing, then at 4 degree Celsius, the 4 degree Celsius, the maximum density is seen. Okay, now if the temperature of water is lowered below 4 degree Celsius, now what happens, the temperature is decreased below 4 degree Celsius, its density decreases. Density decreases and volume increases. So here what happens, we seen that if this is the upper layer of the water, then what happens, if density increases, means it gets the more space than the before ones. Okay, now what happens, again the temperature starts decreasing, and at one temperature what happens, that there is a 0 degree Celsius, and at 0 degree Celsius, as you know that what happens, the upper layer of the water, how the glass inside the upper layer of water is turns into the ice, same thing is happening. That is, this upper layer of the water turns to ice, and the water which is inside the pond, it remains in which state? Liquid state. And because of it, what happens, all the fishes and aquatic plants and animals can live inside the water, and this behavior of the water is called as a anomalous behavior of the water. And what I said, that at generally, like other liquids, water also follow the same rule. Up to which temperature I told you, 3 degree Celsius, up to 3 degree Celsius what happens, this temperature temperature decreases, density increases. Temperature what happens, decrease, and then what happens, it's a density increase. Okay, this rule is there, it follows like others only. Now its temperature is 4 degree Celsius, and this is the 4 degree Celsius temperature. So temperature what happens, again it is decrease, but it's a, and this is the maximum density at this position. And after 4 degree Celsius, okay, if the temperature is here 5 degree Celsius, and here if the temperature is below, now its temperature is 3 degree Celsius, then 3 degree Celsius there, then temperature what happens, at that time the density, temperature decreases, but density what happens, it is density and volume increases. Density decreases and volume increases. Okay, so it means that, and this behavior of the water is called as an anomalous behavior of water. Now in the cold countries, how the aquatic animals remain alive even after the rivers and lake get freezes in the winter. Okay, you see here this layer of the water, it get freeze. If you see here, the ice is there here upper layer, but the water up to 4 degree Celsius are there present inside the pond, and that's why what happens. And as you know that ice is the bad conductor of heat and heat. So this ice is not allow the temperature to decrease, means because of the external temperature, the water from the pond, in the pond's water is not changing its temperature. Who is the barrier here? The ice layer is the barrier for this. Now in cold countries, that's why what happens, the water from the lakes and the river freezes, but the animals remain alive inside it. That is because of the anomalous behavior of the water. Okay, now here one activity there is there. First of all, we'll see this activity in the activities video, and then we will take the discussion on it. Okay,
that addition of salt affects the density of water. Let us do a small experiment to see how. We need a jar of water, potato and salt. Pour the water in a glass.
Now put the potato in the water. It sinks. Now remove the potato. Add some salt to the water and stir it well. Now put the potato in the glass. It floats now. Do you know why? When we add salt in water, the density of the water increases and the potato floats on it. So the addition of salt increases the density of water.
Now we will see one more experiment regarding to the lemon with the same soap, and then we will continue our lecture.
Welcome friends, subscribe this channel and tap the bell icon for latest or any other liquid floats in it. For this we need 2 glasses of water, common salt and 2 lemons. The procedure of this experiment is very simple. To start, fill 2 glasses with common tap water. Now take a lemon and put it in one of the glass and see what happens next. And we can see that the lemon sinks in the water. Now we'll take some salt and we'll add it in the other glass of water. By this we will obtain a salt solution. Mix it well until the salt dissolves in water completely. Now we have obtained a salt solution, which is denser than the common tap water. Now we will take another lemon and we'll put it in this salt solution to see what happens next. Here we can see clearly that this lemon doesn't sink in the water, but it floats in the water. This is because the density of this lemon is less than the density of water, so it floats in water. But on the other hand, the density of the lemon in common water is higher than the density of water, so it sinks. This is the reason why one lemon floats while other one sinks in the water of different properties. This experiment shows that an object which has less density than water floats in it while the density of other object which is higher than the water sinks in it.
Now we saw the activity which is given in the textbook, but we saw the two activities, one with the potato and another with the lemon. So first of all, whatever is activity given, same activity is there that we had seen. So here, first of all, what they do, take 2 big glasses of water. So here it is the first glass and here it is the another second one. Add 4 to 5 spoonful of salt in the water in one glass and dissolve it completely. What we have to do in another, here it is the second glass inside, they add here salt because it is a salty solution, and first glass is the normal tap water is taken. The potato, what happens? And we have to put the potatoes in it. So if you see in the first water, what happens? Potato sinks, it is at the bottom level of the glass, but in the second solution inside, this potato is there, it is floating on the surface of the water. Why this is happening? In the first water, this water's density is more than the density of a potato, okay, and that's why the potato sinks inside the water. So here see what they told you, the density of water in that glass greater due to the dissolves also. First inside what happens, its density is more. The density of the water that in the glass were greater due to the dissolved salt. Here density of water is more. And here density of potato is more. So first water inside, the density of potato is more. That's why what happens, it sinks inside the water. But in second inside, this floats on the surface of the water. Reason behind it is that the dissolved salt solution is there and its density is more, and that's why it floats on the surface of the water. Okay, now we'll see what is given in our book. Here, the density of water in the glass is greater due to the dissolved salt. Okay, means that's why density is more, that's why potato is floating. The potato floats in the water because of increased density. Okay, and here was earlier in the swim in the that's why it is easier to swim in the sea than the whale or lake. Means on seawater we can float because of the density of water. What happens? We float on the surface of the sea water. But when we are trying to swim in the whale water, otherwise river water, it is fresh water and its density is what happens less than density is less, and that's why there are possibilities that the when you are trying to swim, the it is better, possibilities are there, you will sink inside the water. Okay, in the above activity what they told you, salt dissolves in the water. What happens? The salt is there, we are adding in it, salt is dissolving. Who is dissolving? Salt is dissolving in the water, and afterwards it disappears. What happens when it disappears like this? So when it disappear means what happens, the salt particles are there, that is sodium and chloride, they mix into the water. Then when the salt dissolve in water, what they told you, when salt dissolves in the water, its particles spread in water, means the sodium and the chlorine, okay, Na, sodium and chlorine, they floats on the surface, they get what happens, spread into the water, and slowly they become smaller and smaller. It becomes smaller and smaller, ultimately they become small, they cannot be seen. After some time what happens, they become smaller and smaller and we can't see to it. They mix completely with the water, okay. After some time they mix completely with the water, and that is called as a dissolving, okay. Now we will see the three new concepts are there for us. First is the solute, second is the solvent, and next is the solution. Suppose this is a water, okay, and water means H2O. This is salt particles are there. Suppose this is salt, means what? NaCl. Salt is NaCl, and solvent means, and next it is the, so the sodium chloride means salt dissolves in the water. Salt dissolves in the water, and that's why what happens, salt is called as a, it is a solute. The substance which dissolves in the water, dissolves in liquid, it is called as a solute. The substance which dissolves in the water, it is called as a solute. These are the simple definition, but these definitions are there in exam that may be come for the 1 mark. Solvent, the substance in which the solute dissolves. Substance in which solute is dissolved. Solute means what? Salt. Salt is dissolving whom? In water. So water is a solvent. And then last it is a solute. After mixing solute and solvent together, what it forms? It forms the solution. What I said, that when solute and solvent get what happens, combine each other, it forms the solution. Now uses of water according to their properties, that we will see now. So uses of water according to the properties. Water is useful for the transport due to the fluidity. Water is used in transport for because of fluidity, okay. So the falling down from the height is used to generate electricity with the help of generator. Because of the fluidity property, what happens, we can use it as a transport, means we can go from one place to another place by using ships and all. And also it's because of the fluidity, what happens, it falling down from the height, and because of that property, what happens, we can make we can generate electricity with the help of generator. So that of, because of fluidity, what I said, for transport and for generation of the electricity we are using it. Second, water is a good coolant. Water is a good coolant, okay, and used in motor vehicles to control the temperature of the engine. Okay, it is good coolant for us also. If we drink the water in the summer season, we feel very good, okay. So this is the coolant, our body becomes cool, and same thing what happens, it is because of this coolant property, it is used in the motor vehicles to control the temperature of the engine, okay. Now next, many substances are soluble in water, okay. As we know that so many substances are there, they are soluble in water. Water is a, that's why it is called as a universal solvent, and water used as a solvent in factories, laboratories, foodstuffs, and various types of the biological processes occurring in the body, and because, and such as digestion and excretion, it is only because of the property of water, that is it is a good solvent. So here what third property what we seen, it is so many substances are there soluble in water, that's why it is called as a universal solvent. And so it is used as a solvent in factory, laboratory, foodstuffs inside, and in our body, well functioning of our body also, water is a good solvent. And last, water is useful for cleaning purpose such as bathing, washing clothes. Yesterday only I told you it is not possible to take a bath or washing clothes with any other liquid like petrol, diesel or milk. Only water can, what happens, clean the body, and what happens, it can wash the clothes, and you do, it does the various activity. So these are the uses of water. Uses of water inside water is, we said that for generation of electricity, for transport, then it is using as a coolant in the vehicles, then it is a good solvent, soluble in water, that's why it is a universal solvent. And this solvent is there, and because of this property, our body functioning also well when we are drinking the proper quantity of water. And it is also used for washing and the clothes and bathing because of the cleanliness property. So today we had seen the water, today we have finished the water, and the water inside, what we seen that total water inside, properties of water, this is the one of the natural resource, and this is the main natural resource. And inside it we seen that it is fluid, it emerges out from the small holes of the water, small holes of any article. After that we had seen that it takes the shape of any it doesn't have its own shape, but it takes the shape of the utensil which we have putting. Water move from higher level to the lower level. Then we had seen the anomalous behavior of the water, okay, and due to this what happened, density of water also we had seen that because of it ice density, what it is a part of, it is only, it is also a transformation of water, but ice can float on the surface of the water. Then we had seen that anomalous behavior of the water, and in that behavior, because of this anomalous behavior, the living organisms can live inside the water where it, the rivers and the ponds get freezes, then also they can exist in the water. After that we seen the activity which shows that the what density of the water increases, then what happens, the substance is floats on the surface of the water, and when the density of water is less, then what happens, substance sinks into the water, okay. Then afterwards we had seen the different uses of the water, and also we had seen that the solute what is solute, the substance which dissolves in the water is called as a solute. The solvent, the substance which dissolves is called in which the solute dissolves, it is called as a solvent, and the mixing of this is called as a solution. And we seen the properties of water. So today we have finished the natural substance, that natural properties of natural substances, that is the water. And tomorrow we will see the natural see about the soil. So today we will stop here only, and today all of you do the study of this all part whatever I taught you, okay. So we will stop here, okay, thank you.